Hi, this is Bully. Today I am gonna show you how to set up a WordPress blog, a website with SiteGround, so you will have your own website and online portfolio. All right, with that being said, let's go to my computer. All right, before we go over the tutorial, I assume that you already added your website to your SiteGround account. If not, I added a link to my video, how to do it, in the description box below for you guys to check out. Otherwise, all right, let's go to SiteGround.com so we could log in to your account. And this is SiteGround.com. Alright, let's close out the accept all cookies, or just click the accept all cookies button at the bottom first, and then click log in on the top right to log in. Enter your username and password here. In this case, my browser already has my login history, that's why I don't have to enter my username. And this is your SiteGround dashboard. Then click the website's link on top of the page. You should be able to see a list of your websites right here. We are going to use doodlingdemos.com, assuming that is your website that you want to install WordPress. Click the site tools link on the right. Here is the dashboard of your website, and those are all the settings. Click WordPress on the left panel to expand it, and click Install and Manage. Select the first option, WordPress. Click the Select button right here. Scroll down a little bit to check on the form and fill out the form. Make sure the domain name is yours. Leave the main folder as it is and select your language. And enter your username and the email address for the admin info to log into your new website. Enter your password here. Once everything looks good, just look at this option. We don't really need this plugin, so just uncheck that option and then click the install button at the bottom. This can take a while. Ta-da! The WordPress is installed on your website already. And let's click the admin panel to go to the dashboard of your website. This is the dashboard of your website. It's open in a new tab. Let's check out the front end of your website in another tab. And here it is. This is the default WordPress theme that comes with the installation. Let's go back to the back end real quick because we need to install a plugin that says coming soon. Click plugins on the left panel. Click add new. Enter a keyword in the search box on the top right, maintenance, and let's select that plugin, the seed prod. Click the install now and then click the activate button. Once done, skip this page. We don't need to give away our email address here unless you want it. We are in the plugin section right now. Click inactive to make coming soon mode active, and then click set up a coming soon page right above it to edit the coming soon page. Because when you have a new website or a website maintenance, you want to put your website offline so your visitors don't see what goes on behind the scenes when it's not ready yet. Here are the templates that you could choose, and you see all the orange highlights. Those are for free, but you have to give away your email address to get that. So let's pick this free one. It's plain and simple. You could click each element to edit your page, and at the same time you will be able to see whatever you change on the left panel. You can type in the text editor on the left panel also. And let's add a text here. Add whatever you want for your website. Make sure you add the name of your website. Make sure you add something catchy with your branding here, or as simple as that, your website is coming soon. As for the title, you could just add the name of your website. As for the clock icon on the top, you could change it to your website logo if you have a logo already. If not, just leave it as it is or replace it with something else catchy or meaningful. As you could see here, when I type each character, you can also see all the changes on the left panel in that editor too. Let's see, I want to add a link to the name Doodling Web Designs right here. Just highlight the text and you could click that link icon to add your URL address right there, and that text becomes clickable. And then when it looks good, you could click the icon right there and go click the left panel to upload a new file, or go to the media library to see an existing file. Once everything looks good, just click the save button on the top right. It's all safe now. And then you could click the preview button right there to preview your coming soon page. And here it is. Once everything looks good, just close out that tab. And then you could click the X mark on the top right to close it. And then let's go to the front end and refresh the page. As you could see the orange highlight up there on the top right, it means the coming soon mode is on. When you click on that tab, you will be back to the plugin section on the back end. All right, that's all for today's tutorial. I hope you have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you in my next video. Bye now.